Hello friends, in this video, we will take a look at another DC uninterruptible power supply, UPS, which is perfect for routers, IP cameras, home servers, lighting, and other similar devices. Unlike traditional UPS systems, this model does not have an inverter and provides 5, 9, or 12 volts of direct current output. This helps avoid unnecessary conversions and energy losses, significantly improving the device's efficiency. The star of this review boasts impressive battery capacity, the ability to select output voltage, and power combining options. In this video, we'll examine its features in detail, conduct tests for real power output, capacity, and charging time. In the meantime, don't forget to like this video to support it and help it reach a wider audience. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now is the perfect time to do so. The model is the Ruisi MD1 Pro, a DC uninterruptible power supply. It has a declared battery capacity of 25,600 mAh, which is approximately 94.7 watt-hours. The batteries are lithium-ion, and the output ports include USB, 5 volts, up to 2 amps, DC1, also 5 volts, up to 2 amps, DC2, 3, 4, selectable 9 or 12 volts, up to 2 amps each. When setting the same voltage on multiple outputs, the power is combined, and the maximum current on a single port can reach 6 amps. The power supply is external, 19 volts, with a current of 6.32 amps and 120 watts. It supports simultaneous charging and pass-through power to the load. The battery protection includes safeguards against deep discharge, overcharge, and overheating. The UPS comes in a white cardboard box with an image of the device on the front. This form factor has at least a dozen models differing in capacity, power, and the ability to combine multiple ports for higher current output. The packaging is well made, with no loose parts inside. Everything is neatly arranged in separate compartments. The package contents are quite extensive, so let's go over what's included. In my case, the UPS arrived from a marketplace for the internal Chinese market, so the manual is in Chinese characters. I assume there are versions available in English as well. However, it's not difficult to read it using a translator app and a camera. Another related point is the Chinese three-prong plug on the power supply cable. But the connector itself is a standard IEC, so you can either use a cable with the appropriate plug or just replace the plug. The power supply unit is external and fairly powerful, designed for an input voltage of 220 to 240 volts and an output of 19 volts with a current of up to 6.32 amps, which is 120 watts, similar to a high-performance laptop. The package includes four small cables with standard 5.5 by 2.1 millimeters connectors and two adapters for 5.5 by 2.5 millimeters connectors. One of the cables is noticeably thicker than the others, intended for heavy loads. On the front of the device, you'll find all the output connectors, controls, and indicators arranged from left to right, the power and voltage selection button, the confirmation button, and below them, the charge indicator. Next are the power outputs, and on the far right, the power aggregation indicator. I'll go into more detail about these shortly. On the bottom cover, the capacity is listed as 25,600 mAh, which, given the nominal voltage of the lithium-ion batteries, 3.7 volts. Translates to around 95 watt-hours of energy. As I mentioned earlier, there are many models of this UPS, and the one we're reviewing today is the MD1 Pro. On the left side of the case is the connector for the power supply, which is included in the package, with an output voltage of 19 volts. Compared to other similar DC uninterruptible power supplies, you can find a link in the video description where you'll see a list of all the devices of this type that I've reviewed and tested. The top cover of the case is held in place by clips, and they're quite tight. It took some effort to remove it, but I was eager to take a peek inside. The battery pack consists of 8 cells, with each one having a capacity of 3,200 mAh, according to the stated specifications. These wires seem to be for voltage balancing. Judging by their number, I assume the pack is configured in a 2S4P setup, giving an output voltage of 7.4 volts. If I'm correct, this is the BMS, Battery Management System, board which provides protection for the battery pack. Here are a few more angles. Everything seems to be well made in my opinion, but I decided not to go any further with disassembly. Real-world testing, which I'll show you later in this review, is more telling and important. To turn the device on or off, hold down the power button. Under the DC 2, 3, and 4 ports, voltage indicators light up, defaulting to 12 volts on all of them. The aggregation indicator on the right shows that the ports can collectively deliver up to 6 amps. A short press on the power button cycles through the 9 to 12 volt indicators. If you need to change the voltage, hold down the confirmation button. Now ports 2 and 4 are set to 9 volts, while DC 3 remains at 12 volts. If you use only one of the 9 volt ports, you can get up to 4 amps of current. This allows you to configure the ports in any way you need. The settings are saved when you turn the device on and off. If all three are set to the same voltage, say 12 volts, you can get up to 6 amps in total, either from a single port or distributed across several, 3 amps from two ports, or 2 amps from each of the three. In this configuration, DC 2 is set to 9 volts and can deliver 2 amps, while DC 3 and 4 are set to 12 volts and can deliver a total of 4 amps, for example, 1 plus 3, 2 plus 2, or all 4 amps from one port. Similarly, you can aggregate up to 4 amps on DC 2 and DC 3 at 9 volts. USB and DC 1 always provide 5 volts with a current of up to 2 amps. Let's start testing the port power. Currently, all three ports are set to 12 volts, meaning the current from one port should reach up to 6 amps. I'm using the thickest cable provided in the kit. I'll begin increasing the current in 1 amp increments. As the current increases, the voltage drop becomes more noticeable, but it's still within acceptable limits. At 5 amps, the voltage drops to 11.6 volts. At 6 amps, the protection kicks in and the port shuts down. Continuing the test at 5 amps, but now with 0.1 amp increments. At 5.3 amps, the voltage is at 11.57 volts, with a power output of just over 61 watts. On the next step, the protection triggers and the port shuts down. Next, I switched one of the ports to 9 volts, with the maximum current at 12 volts set to 4 amps. I'll increase the current by 0.1 amp increments after reaching 3 amps. At 3.7 amps, the UPS triggers protection. Now, with only one port at 12 volts and a current of up to 2 amps, I immediately begin increasing in 0.1 amp increments. At 1.9 amps, there's a sharp voltage drop, and at the next step, the port shuts down. Similarly, I conducted the test at 9 volts. Now all three ports are switched to 9 volts, with a current aggregation of up to 6 amps. At 5 amps, there's a voltage drop of more than half a volt. I'll continue increasing by 0.1 amps. At 5.5 amps, the port shuts down. With two ports at 9 volts, aggregation reaches up to 4 amps. I switch to 0.1 amp increments. At 3.7 amps, the protection triggers. For the last test at 9 volts, with one port operating and a current of up to 2 amps, the protection kicked in at exactly 2 amps. Next are the 5-volt ports. Starting with DC1, the maximum current, as a reminder, is up to 2 amps. The voltage drop is minimal, even at 2 amps. However, the protection activates, preventing the current from going above 2 amps. Finally, the USB port. For this test, I'm using a U-Green cable. Again, there's a relatively small voltage drop. The protection triggered at 2.2 amps, slightly better than the previous test. In the next test, after checking the power, I connected the UPS to the power supply, and it began charging. The power draw was just over 26 watts. All ports were switched to 12 volts, with the load set at 5 amps. When I turn on the load, the input power increases to over 100 watts, with 26 watts going to battery charging and the rest to the load. Some of the energy is lost in conversion and heat. When I disconnect the load, only the battery charging remains. I lower the current on the load and turn it back on. The same thing happens. The UPS continues charging the batteries and sustaining the electronic load. Now, let's repeat the test with the UPS fully charged. If the power supply is connected to the mains, the load will draw power directly from it, bypassing the batteries. Everything works as expected in this scenario. I decided to test the actual capacity at 12 volts with a current of 4 amps. Let's start. This is a pretty significant load, which could represent a high-performance router combined with a smart home server, a network coordinator, and several IP cameras. In many cases, this much power isn't even necessary. After 1 hour, the UPS delivered nearly 45 watt-hours of energy. The voltage, while showing a slight drop, remains within acceptable limits. At 1.5 hours, it had delivered 73 watt-hours, with a slightly more noticeable voltage drop, but still not critical. A few minutes after that, the UPS shut down. The actual result was 75.6 watt-hours, which is about 80% of the claimed 95 watt-hours. While no one expects 100%, 80% is still a bit disappointing. What does this mean for real-world usage? On average, a good dual-band router consumes about 15 watts, so it could run on this UPS for 5 hours. If you add a mini smart home server that consumes around 10 watts, the runtime would be over 7.5 hours. Together, they could run for about 3 hours. Now the UPS is completely discharged and turned off. I've plugged in a small indicator lamp into the USB port. When I power it on, voltage immediately appears on the ports, as you can see from the lamp. The current power consumption includes both charging the batteries and powering the lamp. After turning off the lamp, only the charging process continues. To determine the charging time, I'm using a smart socket. Here's the power sensor that will help us figure out how long it takes to fully charge the device. I started at 4 p.m. The full charging process took place mostly between 4 o'clock and 8 p.m., during which the power sensor registered about 25 watts. For hours after starting the charge, the power began to drop sharply, and after another 24 minutes, the charging process stopped. So, it takes at least 4 hours to fully charge the UPS from a completely discharged state. Now, let's sum up. The advantages of this device include a good number of output ports, flexible voltage settings on 3 of them, current aggregation, which is useful for heavy loads, decent capacity compared to similar devices, good circuitry with effective protection, a powerful power supply, and reliable bypass function, immediate port activation after power restoration, acceptable full charging time. What I didn't like, the claim capacity is overstated. The actual is slightly over 20,000 milliamp hours. The power output also falls short of the claimed levels, though the aggregation feature still makes it higher than most competitors. I also want to highlight a common mistake when users calculate power consumption based on the power supply specifications. For example, if it says 12 volts and 3 amps, they assume the load will be 36 watts. That's not the case. These parameters are the maximum the power supply can deliver. The actual consumption needs to be measured and will likely be much lower. Knowing this figure and the UPS battery capacity will help you estimate the runtime. That's all for now. I hope you found this video useful and interesting. I'd appreciate your likes, as they help the video reach more people on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, make sure to subscribe to my channel. In the video description, you'll find links to stores where you can order this UPS, as well as other reviews and tutorials on this topic. You'll also find links to my Telegram channels, Facebook page, and a group for smart home discussions. Join us, it'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention, and until next time, peace to everyone.